sitting here making this recording, looking out at gray skies and trees heaving in the wind, and I think it's just about a perfect atmosphere for the day. As you all know, Halloween is my favorite holiday, and so I thought that in addition to doing the poem, I'd do a little something extra this year and just sort of hold forth on what I love about this. You know, I think it was when I was 9 years old and I read a book in the Wishbone series of stories. It was an adaptation of the book Green Tea by Sheridan Le Fanu, about a scholarly man who sees he's working on some project and he starts drinking a lot of green tea, and as a result he sees this strange apparition, like this sort of demonic monkey with red eyes. I always thought that was a really cool story. I mean, it scared the hell out of me as a kid, but I think that's my earliest Halloween memory at any rate. Maybe there was some stuff before that, but I have a very vivid memory of being all terrified, but, you know, thrilled by it. Then, a couple of years later, was when my parents let me stay up late enough to go to the cemetery across from our house late at night on Halloween. That's right, we had a cemetery across the street from our house, which I think is pretty cool. And for years, it was a tradition of mine to go over there at night on Halloween in the hopes that I would see ghosts or monsters or something like that. And I never really did. The closest I ever came to it was one night. I was walking down there, and I saw a little white thing in front of me on the ground. It just sort of hovered there and disappeared. Now, my working theory is that it was probably a skunk. But you don't know. You don't know what strange things are out there. Another time I was out and, late at night, it's dark, I'm walking down there and I hear a snort and hooves running down the road. It was a deer, of course, I'm sure, but still startling to be out alone on Halloween and suddenly hear this big creature, you know, maybe a few yards away. But that's always fun. I've been to that cemetery, you know, nights when it was warm, nights when it was cold. I was there one night on a lovely night, a big rainstorm, and there were these big trees, and they hadn't lost their leaves yet on one side of the cemetery, just heaving and rustling in the wind. It was gorgeous, just a gorgeous night. So that's one of the things I enjoy about Halloween. And then of course, I mean, you know, I would usually go watch a scary movie or read a scary book or something. I even I composed one of my poems. I'll link to it below. While I was sitting in this old cemetery, and it is old. I mean, it's like, I think all the graves in there date to early 1800s. You know, most of the people there born 1700s. It's a really wonderful atmosphere. Every kid should be lucky enough to grow up across the street from a graveyard. That's what I say. If you're wondering what my favorite scary movie would be, I'd probably have to go with the movie The Omen, the 1976 one with Gregory Peck and Lee Remick. It's a really good movie, and it's not that gory. The premise is basically Gregory Peck is this ambassador who gradually realizes that his son is the Antichrist. And what I like about it, for my money, even though it's sort of the same diabolical horror scheme as like The Exorcist, for my money, it's way scarier than The Exorcist was. Precisely because The Exorcist was really just, it was based heavily on gross out, and I'm not a fan of that. The Omen is much more cerebral. I mean, there's a few gory death scenes in it, don't get me wrong, but for the most part, it's more about a mood. And the opening theme music is just terrifying. It's called the Ave Satani, or Hail Satan. Ugh, it's scary stuff. Other good movies. One that, you know, I didn't like this movie at all when I first saw it as a kid. I was, I think, too young for it. But The Haunting. This is a 1960s movie, black and white. Julie Harris was in it. It's based on a Shirley Jackson story. I think the story is called The Haunting of Hill House, if I remember correctly. And this one, you know, it's one, I was bored, you know, as a kid. I'm like, where are the monsters? But thinking about it now, it's actually really an interesting idea for a story, because it's sort of, there's a bit of ambiguity, you know. Are there ghosts? Is the place haunted? Or is the protagonist of the story, Eleanor, just losing her mind? I guess it sort of comes down on the side of there are ghosts in a way, but it's interesting. It's a very interesting concept. I like it a lot. Other movies I've enjoyed. Alien is a good horror flick. I mean, there aren't a lot of great horror movies out there, in my opinion. A lot of the ones now tend to be just gory slasher flicks, which I have no use for that, really. I tend to like more the cerebral, you know, ambiguous horror. I mean, because what makes something really scary to me is when you can't say for sure if there's actually anything supernatural going on or if it's just an insane person. I love that idea.
Night might howl in the chimney cows, and the bat in the moonlight flies, and inky clouds like funeral shrouds sail over the midnight skies. When the footpads quail at the night bird's wail, and the black dogs bay at the moon, then is the spectre's holiday, then is the ghost high noon. Oh, then is the ghost high noon.
Ghosts High Noon. I love it. I love it. Is it any wonder that Ruddy Gore is my favorite Gilbert and Sullivan? Yeah. I love it for so many reasons, but I'm sure the supernatural element figures into it. Always listen to it on Halloween. It's a tradition. If you want to see a really... Well, I know this will be controversial. I love the Stanford Savoyard's performance of it from 2012 or 13, I think. It's on YouTube. If you search Stanford Savoyard's Ruddy Gore, you're bound to find it. They did sort of a Tim Burton style thing, which I love. I've always wondered, why the heck doesn't Tim Burton just go ahead and do Ruddy Gore? I mean, it seems perfect for him, right? I mean, and if Helena Bonham Carter wasn't born to play Mad Margaret, I don't know what, but he's never done it. And you know what else? I mean, the Stanford Savoyards do it about as well as it could be done, in my opinion. So look that one up. I guess we can't really talk about scary stuff without talking a little bit about H.P. Lovecraft. I read him when I was in college. This was well into my obsession with spooky stuff. And, you know, you hear the name Lovecraft getting tossed around whenever you're into that. And so eventually I decided, well, I better read this guy. And I read Call of Cthulhu. And honestly, I thought it was just okay. I mean, it's a good premise for a story. I didn't like the last third of it that well. I thought that kind of demythologized the monster too much, if you will. But I did like stories of his, like The Music of Eric Zahn. That's a very good story. My favorite Lovecraft story has to be The Haunter of the Dark. I really, really like that one. I'm surprised it's not one that gets referenced more. It's in my opinion, a very good horror story. And a lot of Lovecraft's poetry was very, very much to my taste. Because, you know, I'd been into poetry before that, what with the Gilbert and Sullivan thing. But to discover somebody writing scary poetry, that was cool to me. I think his poem Nemesis is one of my favorite poems. And it's very dark for a number of reasons. The line I always think of from it is, "Oh, great was the sin of my spirit, and great is the reach of its doom. Not the pity of heaven can cheer it, nor can respite be found in the tomb. Down the infinite eons come beating the wings of unmerciful gloom." To me, that's just brilliant. I love that poem. And so that more even than his stories is really what I admired about Lovecraft. Because, well, you know, if you read the blog, I've talked ad nauseum about Lovecraft and what I think of him. I think all of us horror writers now have sort of a love-hate relationship with Lovecraft, because you've got the, you know, obviously the whole issue with him being racist is well documented, and that really hurts. I mean, he's never going to have wide appeal because of that. But his brand of horror, his cosmic horror, is something that I think a lot of us do seek to emulate, because it's a scary idea, the indifference of the universe. It's not, I mean, granted, it's a very different sort of horror than the proverbial ghosts rattling chains and stuff like that, like he says. But it's still an interesting concept, and one that I like to think can inform horror to a great degree. Because ultimately, all horror and all fear is fear of the unknown. Which is why, I mean, I think a big reason we have Halloween at this time of year, you know, you can go back through all the old festivals, you know, the Celtic festival. Spelled something like Samhain. I have no idea how you pronounce that. Ancient, to pronounce it properly, I'm not sure. But, you know, all the festivals that you have this time of year, I mean, it's winter is, as George R.R. Martin would say, coming, and darkness is falling on the land. And darkness is synonymous with fear, because darkness is something that, you know, it by its nature, you can't see what's in the darkness. You don't know what's out there. And when you don't know what's out there, I mean, well, our brains are designed to be afraid of it, naturally, because for primitive man, there was a lot to be afraid of in the dark. You didn't know what was out there, and it was probably more bad than good. So that's why I think we have all this spooky stuff, not to get too much of an anthropologist on you, but, you know, you bring in the harvest, you bring in the food, and then, you know, well, it's going to get bad now, because there's going to be a whole lot of darkness for a while. And of course, there's always been this idea of, well, we can ward off the evil spirits or what have you with other evil-looking things. That's one thing I've never gotten. Like, why did they think that they could keep the evil spirits out of the churches with gargoyles and so forth? I mean, it seemed to me odd that you would be like, here's this demonic-looking monster, is basically saying we've already got some, we don't need any more? I don't know. Anyway, discuss it among yourselves. ¶¶
My name is John Wellington Wells. I'm a dealer in magic and spells, in blesses and curses and ever-filled purses, in prophecies, witches and elves. If you want a photo to make tracks, if you met a rich uncle in wax, you've got to look in on the resident in number 70, Simmery X.
One question that I guess this is bound to generate, and that I've maybe never addressed this, or maybe I have way back when on the blog, I don't know, is, do I believe in ghosts, or monsters, or any of these creatures? And the answer is basically no. I read a lot of reports of, you know, supposedly haunted houses and all these ghost legends and things, because they're great ideas for stories. But most of them, you know, you'll read something about a haunted house, and it's like, well, we think it's haunted because it's cold, or, you know, sometimes the door shuts, or, oh, it's strange smells in the ancient basement or something. And it's like, well, of course there is. I mean, 95% of the stories you read about hauntings are, you know, most of them aren't hoaxes. Once in a while, you'll read about something that somebody actually purposefully putting on a hoax. More often than not, it's just people wanting to imagine something or wanting to believe in something, and they're in a place that's evocative of it, like a house or a theater, someplace with a lot of history. And it's fun to believe in it. I mean, Lord knows, I know it's fun. But most cases of reported hauntings are nothing. Once in a while, you'll read something a little more extreme, where it's a little bit harder to explain. But again, it's hard to substantiate even these things. So basically, my ultimate answer is I don't really believe in ghosts. Now, I do believe there's things about the universe which we don't understand. There's things about the nature of reality that we don't understand and that maybe we can't understand. This is the other reason to tie this back in with the Lovecraft discussion, why I kind of like his brand of horror, because that's probably the most plausible horror story to me, is that, yeah, there is stuff out there in the cosmos, because the universe is a big place. There are probably some very strange things out there. I mean, there's strange things in the oceans that we're still trying to get a handle on. And so it's not at all out of the question in my mind that there could be some pretty strange stuff out there in the universe, and that one day we may encounter it. And, you know, it's sort of like that Arthur C. Clarke quote, any sufficiently advanced technology is indistinguishable from magic. It's something similar in that, you know, naturally occurring beings, there's nothing supernatural about things. There's nothing, you know, outside the laws of physics, perhaps, about things that could be out there. They're just very strange and different than what we're used to, and so much so that they seem effectively to be monsters. That I could very much believe. As far as ghosts, I don't really see much evidence of that. People will say, like, well, ghosts exist because they have unfinished business or something like that. Well, who doesn't have unfinished business when they die? I would say almost everyone does. So I don't really buy into that, even though it's fun to think about. So why do I spend so much time on Halloween and ghostly stuff and whatnot if I don't really believe in it? Well, I guess the honest answer is that it's part of just my interest in stuff that's weird and offbeat generally. If you read my blog, you know, I've been doing that for a number of years now, and I sort of like things that are different than what most people are doing. Part of the thing is, if I have a philosophy of life, and that sounds awfully dramatic, but I guess that's the best way to put it, it's that if you're just doing what everybody else is doing, you're only going to get average to middling results. If you want to stand out, if you want to do something extraordinary, you have to be looking at stuff that is weird, that is strange, that is different. I mean, it's of necessity. I mean, we're socialized to a great degree to do what everybody else is doing, and to an extent that's important because it's the basis of civilization. But if you want to really stand out, you do have to look at stuff that's strange. And I do that in a lot of ways, or I try to anyway. And ghosts and things like that are no different. If you want to find out interesting things about the world, you have to look into areas where there seems to be something strange going on. There seems to be something offbeat. And that's why, you know, despite the fact that I don't really believe in it, I mean, there's always that 1% of doubt, of uncertainty, of we don't know what's out there in the dark. We don't know what's going on where we can't see. We just see glimpses of odd things that don't add up, and you start to wonder what else is out there. And, I mean, if there's one thing I can say with certainty, it's that we don't understand everything. I think everyone agrees on that. The world, humans do not fully comprehend the nature of the world. And, you know, there's stuff out there yet to be discovered, and the only way you're going to find it is if you're interested in the weird and the odd and the offbeat. So I think that really is behind it. Plus, it's a lot of fun, of course. I mean, I think if you've made it all the way through this, you must agree with me that it is a hell of a lot of fun to think about.
Flame and fire, demon souls come here in shoals, this fearful deed inspire. Appear, appear, appear. Noisome hags of night, imps of deadly shade, pallid ghosts, arise in hosts, and lend me all your aid.
Well, this about wraps it up for my show. I'll be going out for my usual Halloween walk and posting whatever spooky pictures I can get of anything that happens to be out there on the old Ohio landscape. I just want to thank you guys for being here and listening to this and for sharing Halloween with me. It's a great holiday, my favorite holiday. I hope you guys enjoy it as much as I do. Thank you all for your support, and I'll see you around on the blogosphere and on Twitter. Happy Halloween, everybody.
And then each ghost with his lady toast to their cha-cha beds take flight, with a kiss perhaps on her lengthened chaps and a crisply grim goodnight, till the welcome knell of the midnight bell rings forth its jolliest tune, and ushers in our next high holiday, the dead of the night's high noon.